Welcome to Lab 360, for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. The last time we visited the moon was half a century ago. We've launched multiple spacecrafts across our solar system and learned about faraway worlds during that period. But astronomers are still pondering over the rocky planet that appears in our night sky. Many of the moon's mysteries have been solved thanks to the Apollo missions, but there are still some unanswered questions, including a couple that arose as a result of the samples brought back by the Apollo astronauts. Now, with the Artemis missions underway, there's a lot more waiting to be discovered. The primary objectives of NASA's Artemis missions are to send astronauts to the moon to establish the first long-term presence, and to learn what is required to send the first astronauts to Mars. But it also has plans to accomplish a lot more than that. The Lunar Vulcan Imaging and Spectroscopy Explorer, Lunar-VISE, and the Lunar Explorer Instrument for Space Biology Applications, LEIA, will be sent to the moon as part of one of the agency's many scientific missions to investigate the mysterious Gruithuisen Domes, geological features that have perplexed scientists for years. The two investigations that have been chosen will address crucial scientific questions about the moon. Lunar-VISE will investigate a unique form of lunar volcanism to learn more about the geologic processes of early planetary bodies that have been preserved on the moon. And LEIA will look at how yeast, a model organism used to investigate DNA damage response and repair, reacts to the moon's low gravity and radiation environment. Over the course of 10 days, Lunar-VISE will investigate the peak of one of the Gruithuisen domes to learn how these domes, which are thought to have been formed by a sticky magma, were constructed without the use of liquid water or plate tectonics. This has been a long-standing puzzle for space scientists. Meanwhile, the yeast Saccharomyces cerevisiae, an important model of human biology, will be delivered to the lunar surface and studied in response to radiation and lunar gravity via LEIA. The data collected by this expedition will be used to supplement information from earlier biological research, allowing scientists to better understand how partial gravity and true deep space radiation affect biological systems. For many years, NASA scientists have been baffled by the Gruithuisen domes. They're a geological puzzle. These domes are unique from the surrounding landscape, which is covered with ancient hardened basaltic lava flows, according to observations from the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter. How such silicic magmas formed on the moon is the real enigma. Water and plate tectonics are two components that often lead to the formation of silicic volcanoes on Earth. Scientists are forced to ponder, how did the Gruithuisen domes emerge without these critical components on the moon? Will we finally get an answer to this question? Only time will tell, and perhaps the Artemis mission will be the deciding factor. What do you guys think? Drop in your comments below and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. Welcome to Lab 360, where we bring you all the latest happenings from the world of astronomy. NASA is preparing to bring its CAPSTONE spacecraft to launch soon and travel to the moon, and it will provide a massive stepping stone for the Artemis mission soon. The spacecraft is only the size of a microwave oven, and it weighs around 55 pounds only. Its main goal is to demonstrate an experimental orbit for the coming NASA Gateway, a lunar outpost for its future missions. CAPSTONE is a CubeSat that NASA turned into a spacecraft that is only 55 pounds in mass and takes on the size of a microwave oven. According to NASA, the team is preparing to send a small satellite that will help the company determine massive information for its future Artemis mission. CAPSTONE, which stands for Cislunar Autonomous Positioning System, Technology Operations, and Navigation Experiment, will help the company determine more about how the moon's orbit works. The CAPSTONE satellite would be the first spacecraft that would look into this and bring answers to NASA that will help its future mission to the moon. The space agency is preparing to set up a lunar outpost on the moon in its upcoming mission towards it, but it would not send its spacecraft right then and there. It will focus on the CAPSTONE that would bring answers to the lunar orbit before it goes on for the real deal. NASA's Gateway is the lunar outpost venture of the company for the upcoming Artemis moon mission, and it would help in setting up camp for the future. NASA is not shying away from showcasing many of the technology that will come for the Artemis moon mission, and it will focus on bringing the public much information about all things regarding the upcoming venture. One of the latest ventures of NASA is the wet dress rehearsal of the Space Launch System, SLS, rocket bound for the moon. The company is also focusing on transportation methods that will be available while on the lunar surface, and not only a vehicle that will take them from the planet to its natural satellite. A planned electric vehicle is coming to replace the 1980s Astrovan, and it is with EV manufacturer Canoo to fulfill the car's design and technology come to its mission. Of course, NASA is also preparing its astronaut candidates for the Artemis mission, as it would bring the first woman to the moon. Many preparations are set in place to ready the upcoming mission, as it would be a significant one, as it would be the return to the moon after several decades since the last. CAPSTONE will help set up a massive advancement on the future moon mission, and it will do so despite it being a small spacecraft. Before Gateway launches for its purpose, the CAPSTONE will provide an experimental test on its orbit. We cannot wait for the Artemis mission to kick off. About you? Drop in your comments to let us know, and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360, because in space we trust. Voyager 1 is a space probe launched by NASA on September 5, 1977, as part of the Voyager program to study the outer solar system and interstellar space beyond the Sun's heliosphere. More than four decades after its launch, the Voyager 1 probe is still exploring interstellar space, but it has encountered an issue that mystifies and baffles the spacecraft's team on Earth. Voyager 1 continues to operate well, despite its advanced age and 14.5 billion mile distance from Earth. And it can receive and execute commands sent from NASA, as well as gather and send back science data. But the readouts from the Attitude Articulation and Control System, or AACS, which control the spacecraft's orientation in space, don't match up with what Voyager is actually doing. The AACS ensures that the probe's high-gain antenna remains pointed at Earth so Voyager can send data back to NASA. Due to Voyager's interstellar location, it takes light 20 hours and 33 minutes to travel one way. So the call and response of one message between NASA and Voyager take 2 days. So far, the Voyager team believes the AACS is still working, but the instrument's data readouts seem random or impossible. The system issue hasn't triggered anything to put the spacecraft into safe mode yet. That's when only essential operations occur, so engineers can diagnose an issue that would put the spacecraft at risk. And Voyager's signal is as strong as ever, meaning the antenna is still pointed toward Earth. The team is trying to determine if this incorrect data is coming directly from this instrument or if another system is causing it. According to a NASA release, until the nature of the issue is better understood, the team cannot anticipate whether this might affect how long the spacecraft can collect and transmit science data. A mystery like this is sort of par for the course at this stage of the Voyager mission, said Suzanne Dodd, project manager for Voyager 1 and 2 at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in a statement. The spacecraft are both almost 45 years old, which is far beyond what the mission planners anticipated. It's also in interstellar space, a high radiation environment that no spacecraft has flown in before. So there are bound to be some big challenges for the engineering team. If the team doesn't determine the source of the issue, they may just adapt to it. Or if they can find it, the issue may be solved by making a software change or relying on a redundant hardware system. Voyager has already relied on backup systems to last as long as it has. In 2017, the probe fired thrusters that were used during its initial planetary encounters during the 1970s, and they still worked after remaining unused for 37 years. The aging probes produce very little power per year, so subsystems and heaters have been turned off over the years so that critical systems and science instruments can keep operating. Voyager 2, a twin spacecraft, continues to operate well in interstellar space 12.1 billion miles from Earth. By comparison, Neptune, the farthest planet from Earth, is, at most, only 2.9 billion miles away. Both probes were launched in 1977 and have far exceeded their original purpose to fly by planets. Now, they have become the only two spacecraft to gather data from interstellar space and provide insights about the heliosphere, or the bubble created by the Sun that extends beyond the planets in our solar system. Here's hoping the Voyager team is able to determine the issue or find a way around it, so the Voyager can continue with the great work it has done for the past 45 years. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360, for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy.
Bye.